I will trust. morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship with us. We are a small but mighty little group today. Thanks to Joyful Hearts for leading us in worship. And then we have got a guest today. Pastor Ruth is here as Ivy is out on a well-deserved vacation. I just have a couple announcements. Teddy Bear Band, if you guys missed it, so much fun. Pretty sure it's going to become an annual event. Just a great time for the littles, for the adults. It's so much fun. And then in your bulletin, I'm not going to read it all, but there are some highlights about fall, new stuff coming up. So check that out. And I think that's all I have this morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's so good to be with you. I'm Pastor Ruth Sorensen-Prokish, and I'm filling in for Pastor Ivy today. We'll begin together with our confession and our forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the God of manna, the God of miracles, the God of mercy. Amen. Drawn to Christ and seeking God's abundance, let us confess our sin. God, our provider, help us. It is hard to believe there is enough to share. We question your ways when they differ from the ways of the world in which we live. We turn to our own understanding rather than trusting in you. We take offense at your teaching and your ways. Turn us again to you. Where else can we turn? Share with us the words of eternal life and feed us for life in the world. Amen. Beloved people of God, in Jesus, the manna from heaven, you are fed and nourished. By Jesus, the worker of miracles, there is always more than enough. Through Jesus, the bread of life, you are shown God's mercy. You are forgiven and loved into abundant life.
Amen.
Praise. Take my hands and let them move.
his risen life to serve you continually through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. We hear our first lesson for this morning.
Careful then how you live, not as unwise people, but as wise, making the most of the time, because the days are evil. Do not be foolish, but understand that the will of the Lord is. Do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, as you sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs among yourselves, singing and making melody to the Lord in your hearts, giving thanks to God the Father at all times and for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
This one, I'd like to welcome any kids to come forward. I guess some kids will join me for a few minutes. Excellent. Come on up. Gather around this table over here. Good morning. My name is Pastor Ruth. What's your name? Lizeth? Weston? Ann? Reagan? Nice to meet you. I'm so glad to be here today. So I have a question for you. Who do you really, really like to sit down at a table with and have a snack or a meal? Who do you like to have snacks or meals with? Your parents and your sister, how about you? Your family? Do you have a favorite meal to eat together? What was that? Yeah, okay, cool. I have a favorite person that I like to have lunch with. And you don't know me at all, but I'm wondering if you can guess who that person is, and I'll give you a hint. You know her, and on Sunday mornings, she sits up here. I don't know if she got Sunday school. She's taller than me, and she has the first start of her name, like, I'm Pastor Ruth, and she is Pastor... Oh, you got it! Good! Awesome! One of my favorite people to sit down and have a meal with is Pastor Ivy. And you know what? We did that last week. Here, we had pizza. And she walked me through the sanctuary, and she told me about worship here at Living Waters. And she said, the kids here are amazing. Ivy's one of my favorite people to sit down and have a meal with, because I know that we get to talk together, and I get to listen to her stories, and she listens to my stories. And I always walk away from that feeling loved. There's another table that we all are invited to, that we get to come to, and remember that we are loved, that we are known, we are listened to, no matter what. Do you know what table that is? This one, close, yeah, it's in the sanctuary. Do you would say the table here, where we have communion, where we share in the Lord's Supper. I want you to remember that when you have communion, or you have a blessing for communion, that is a table where you are always known and you're always welcome. And every time you come to that table, you get to remember that God loves you. All the time, no matter what. You think you can do that? It's fun to see you today and get to know you a little bit. Let us pray, and then you can go back to your seats. Good and gracious God, we give you thanks for the tables you set before us, for your grace and your mercy and your love. I give you thanks for these gifts, for the tables that they sit at with their parents, with their siblings, that they get to remember that they are loved. Give them your peace today and always. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thanks for coming up and being with me today. It's nice to meet you. You can head on back to your seats. Glasses, masks, hair, microphone. A lot to keep track of these days. Alright. The gospel for today comes from the Gospel of John in the 6th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. The Jews then disputed among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? So Jesus said to them, very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. For my flesh is the true food, and my blood is true drink. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate, and they died. But the one who eats this bread will live forever. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May the peace of Christ fill your hearts and nourish your souls. Amen. Body of Christ at Living Waters, I'm so glad to be with you today for worship, to share in this meal, and in the Word of God. I'm Pastor Ruth Sorensen Prokish. I'm a pastor in the ELCA, but currently serving as a spiritual director. Your pastor, Ivy, and I grew up together at church. We were confirmed together, and we take great joy in walking this path of ministry together. According to her, you are delightful people of God here in this time and in this place, striving to bring joy and love to your neighbors. You are working together to reach out and share God's love in new ways as we navigate this collective reality together. So thank you for doing the work of serving your neighbor. Thank you for doing the work in love. Now, I didn't come here to talk about Pastor Ivy, although I have some very good stories about her. I came here to talk about bread, the bread of life, and popovers. Growing up, I have some very specific memories of getting dressed up and going downtown with my mom to Dayton's. Sometimes we went downtown to shop for a special occasion. Sometimes it was just a special mother-daughter date, but it always included lunch at the River Room. Anybody remember the River Room? There are my people. Great. In my mind as a kid, it didn't get any fancier and going downtown for lunch at the River Room. The chandeliers, the huge mirrors on the walls, the linen napkins and the servers in their black and white uniforms, table after table of ladies who lunch and men in suits. I know that I automatically sat up straighter my best manners on those mother-daughter outings because those tables felt so special. Now, a little history for you. In 1959, Dayton's bought the downtown department store Schuneman's, and that purchase included Schuneman's cafeteria called the River Room. Dayton's River Room continued through Marshall Field's and Macy's until February of 2013. From the very beginning of Dayton's version of River Room, they were known for their popovers, a step up from the traditional bread basket. They made hundreds of popovers every single day. So I contend that it is impossible to think about downtown Dayton's or the River Room without also thinking about popovers. They were perfection. When they closed, I figured it's time to learn how to make those amazing popovers for myself. I mean, how hard can it be, right? It's just egg and milk and butter and flour and salt. Great. I gathered my ingredients, I mixed them up, I put them in the oven, looking forward to recreating the magic of those special outings with my mom. Friends, what came out of the oven was not even close to a popover. They were really more like hockey pucks. Not only were they not special, they were not edible. All bread, it turned out, is not equal. Every 3 years, we enter into a stretch in the Gospel of John known as the Bread Discourse. Jesus uses bread as a teaching tool throughout John. So we spend our time thinking about bread too. Manna in the wilderness, Jesus as the bread of life, the living bread, the bread that comes down from heaven. This isn't the first or the last time that Jesus uses bread as a teaching tool. Just a few weeks ago, we heard about the feeding of the 5,000. And later in the gospel, Jesus shows us what this call to service and love looks like around the Passover table. I contend that it is impossible to think about the bread of life without also thinking about the grace of God. This bread, this body of Christ, is known for infusing God's grace right into our very being to go out with us into the world. This bread is special. It's a tangible reminder that we are beloved. And this table is special because God sets a place for each one of us. It's not your traditional bread basket. And it's not something that we can recreate on our own. This is a gift. This is the bread of heaven. When I think about Jesus inviting us to this meal, it feels like how I felt walking into the River Room as a little girl with my mom, a sense of awe and excitement. Those baskets of popovers, a symbol that this is special time. Bread plays a central role in our scriptures because God knows that we understand bread. We understand the feel of it in our hands, the smell, the taste. This isn't about complicated theological theories that we have to memorize or about being able to do brave feats of skill and muscle or even requirements to check to make sure that we have our lives put together enough to be included. We take this meal as gift, and it strengthens and nourishes us to do the hard work of looking out for our neighbor, of serving others, of being humble, forgiving, being generous, and finally trusting that death does not have the final word for us. Jesus gives himself for our nourishment, for the sake of the world, for every table, for every need, for every one of us, and our daily bread to nourish us with that forgiveness and with that grace to love God and love our neighbors. Jesus gives himself for us because that's who Jesus is. So this meal that we take part in throughout our lives of faith is a combination of Jesus' promise of presence with us, God's grace, and the animating force of the Holy Spirit. But unlike my trips downtown, there are no dress requirements, nor do we even have to come on our best behavior. This bread was blessed at that upper room table where the disciples gathered, and they were scared and confused. And Jesus, knowing what was yet to come, paused to wash feet and feed his friends. Jesus prepared a meal out of love, for love. Jesus prepared that meal knowing that his friends were going to experience fear and grief. They weren't going to know what to do next, and they weren't going to have him physically present much longer. Maybe you know what those disciples were going through. Maybe you know what it feels like to be scared and confused and not to know what to do next. Maybe you know what it feels like to be grieving or to be a bit of a mess. Welcome. This is God's table, and there is a place for you. So something to think about as we join in this holy meal together today. When we pray the Lord's Prayer, as we will in a few moments, give us this day our daily bread. We aren't just asking for bread, but for all the things that we need to live fully and engaged in the world around us. When we pray, give us this day our daily bread, we're praying for all of us. Because if one of us doesn't have bread for today, we all suffer. Bread can look like justice, safe housing, good work, public health, good education, companionship, all the things we give thanks for around the table. When we pray and when we eat this meal, we're reorienting ourselves from our individual needs to the needs of the world around us, asking that God make us visible signs of Christ in the world. Nourished by Christ, then we are strengthened to be the body of Christ together for the sake of the world. So I wonder what that looks like for you. And I wonder what that looks like to your neighbor. I wonder what it would be like if the next time you're gathered around that table with the people that you love to share a meal with, if you ask them, what do you need to feel nourished? And I wonder what it would be like if we really listened. If we asked and if we listened, we might hear some surprising things. And then I wonder what it would be like if the next time we prayed the Lord's Prayer and we said, give us this day our daily bread, we remembered what our family and friends said they needed to be nourished. And we prayed for those things. Try it this week and see what happens in your heart and in your relationships and maybe even out in the world. Friends in Christ, this is God's table, and all are welcome. May you be nourished and strengthened by the bread of life for the week to come. And may you be the loving hands and feet of Christ. Amen.
us to ask faithful questions and open our minds to new ideas. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of creation, mend the earth, cool warming oceans and preserve melting ice caps. Increase our awareness of changing climate patterns and reveal new approaches to the ecological challenges we face. Shield those in the path of hurricanes, fires, and flood, and restore places where drought conditions have changed the landscape. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of all nations, direct our leaders. Grant them courage to lay aside political grudges and renew their determination to address difficult conflicts. Guide them in the work of reconciliation and peace. Open our ears and our minds to truly hear one another as we seek to live together as one community. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of compassion, tend to the wounded. Rescue those tormented by mental illness or mired in addiction. Ease the anxiety of those struggling with dementia. Come quickly to help all who are grieving and all those who suffer in mind, body, and spirit. We ask you to wrap your loving and healing arms around Rudy, John, Ron, John, Barbara, Sarah, Tom, Donna, Holly, Jackie, Marlene, Mary Jane, Caitlin, Lori, Mary, Colleen, Leah, Sue, and Linnea, Judy, Kay, and Bill, Jonah, and Brendan. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of resurrection, bring us to new life. Give us the living bread from heaven through which we abide in your love. And on the last day, raise us with all the saints to eternal life. Continue to guide those who mourn, especially the family and friends of Dora Mollicher. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for patience, perseverance, and compassion as we walk through another challenging spike of COVID and the rise of dangerous variants. Give wisdom to those who bear the load of making decisions with widespread consequences. Heal the suffering of those hospitalized by the virus and give strength to all who are caring for them. Protect those who are unable to receive a vaccine, including our children. Curb the widespread misinformation and mistrust of our scientific communities who are working diligently to end the spread of this virus. Help us to love one another as you have loved us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We lift these and all our prayers to you, O God, confident in the promise of your saving love through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you for the gift of your offering. There's a basket outside the doors where you came in. Your gifts go to fund not only ministry here at Living Waters, but the ministries across the ELCA and in all of our communities. So let us give thanks and pray our offering prayer. Great God, you are the giver of life and all that is good. Accept our humble gifts and multiply them. Accept our humble hearts and mold them. Accept our humble lives and transform them, that we might live in the power of the resurrection, willing to risk all for your kingdom. In the name of Jesus, we offer these gifts, and in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. In the night in which he was betrayed, disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Together, let us pray the prayer that Jesus teaches us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
I invite you to take your cups and to peel back the top layer. This is the body of Christ, given for you. And the next layer, this is the blood of Christ, shed for you. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Let us pray. Jesus, bread of life, we have received from your table more than we could ever ask. As you have nourished us in this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray.
Amen.
Hear the blessing. By your hands, may love be shared. By your voice, may peace be spoken. By your eyes, may beauty be seen. And by your ears, may truth be heard. And by your life, may the song of Christ be sung. Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.